Strongman nations, China, Russia, Turkey, Iran, North Korea, they continue to make gains around the world. Consider this, though. They have a combined GDP that's not that far away from the United States and a much larger combined military. So what does their power mean for the rest of the world? And are we going to be the sheriff that ultimately has to defend the rest of the world? Joining me now to discuss, retired Captain Chuck Nash, former U.S. Navy aviator. Captain Nash, it's been too long. Glad you could make the show tonight.
Charles, it's always a pleasure to be with you anytime.
Yeah, so I put together some numbers. So you've got China, Russia, Turkey, Iran, North Korea, combined GDP over $15 trillion, combined military, 14.4 million. Three of these nations have nuclear capabilities. The other two probably will real soon. That's very competitive with the stats for America. They know this. They know that President Trump has to deal with the Congress, his own political party, a hostile media. How do we navigate a world with these strongmen who have grand ambitions? Because they all do.
Yeah, Charles, most of them are rational actors, and they're not really joined together in any appreciable way with treaties, mutual defense, or otherwise. Talking GDP, I think the U.S. GDP is a little over $19 trillion. EU is about a little less than that, probably about $17 trillion. And then, you know, you get down to the $15 trillion that you were talking about with the bad guys. The other thing about the use of military power is that the president holds two roles. He's the chief executive, but he's also the commander-in-chief. And the commander-in-chief, if he senses the need to use U.S. forces, either in a defensive manner or to respond to a threat, he can do that unilaterally. Now, he has to consult with Congress if he wants to put troops in for a long period someplace, but to act immediately in the defense of U.S. national interests or our allies, he can act unilaterally.
Did you say they were rational or irrational actors?
Rational. They are rational actors.
Really?
Vladimir Putin. Vladimir Putin is not a nut job. Vladimir Putin is acting on a plan, and I think he doesn't want to restore the old Soviet Union. He wants to restore the Imperial Russia. So he wants that powerful Russia, but if you look at their GDP, it's like, I think it's like $1.5 trillion.
Sure.
Which is, you know, it's chump change.
Yeah. It was a lot more too. $2.3 trillion a couple of years ago. I want to quickly, because we have less than a minute though.
Sure.
China and Russia, they're going to have these big war games thing. I'm talking strategic bombers, jets, everything in a couple of weeks from now. What message will that be sending to the world?
Well, I think it's Russia reaching out to China and vice versa. But if you look historically at China, and I really do take history into account when I do my analysis, if you look at the history of Russia, their threat has been and always shall be to the east. Their threat is really an expanding China into their eastern hinterlands.
Right.
That's
right.
What they're worried about.